to fit the bridge in. Didn't say any more, really. Honey, I'm knocking at your door. Hand me a flickering flame.
From St. Lucia, Steve. I'm very distinct. Alan, I'm very nice to be here. I have to admit that Steve's a real professional because he and I are both very, very down in the dumps because we were at Sandy Park this afternoon.
Disaster.
Here's a song called Low Down in the Broom. Paul and I went to Exmouth School, where it was approved at the time. We were in that crossover bit where it was a grammar for a bit and then comprehensive, and Paul was the fine classical guitarist of Exmouth. In fact, he was the only classical guitarist in Exmouth at the time, and he learnt this wonderful arrangement of a fine old English folk song called Low Down in the Broom. It's one of the nicest tunes. These songs collected way, way back when. So this is something we first played in Exmouth School Common Room, and we haven't played it for a while, but we'll play it for you tonight. This is a gorgeous arrangement. A fine English folk song.
Oh, pardon my dear.
sing song. But unaccompanied by Bruce. He doesn't do any of ours.
Well, it's early in the morning, factory whistle blows. Man rises from bed and puts on his clothes. And he takes his lunch and walks out in the morning light. It's the work, it's the work, and just the work in life. Through the mansions of fear, through the mansions of pain, see my daddy walking through those factory gates in the rain. Factory takes his hearing, factory gives him life. It's the work, it's the work, and just the work in life. End of the day, factory whistle cries. Men walk through these gates with death in their eyes. And you just better believe it, boys, somebody's gonna get hurt tonight. It's the work, it's the work, and just the work in life. And it's early in the morning, factory whistle blows. Man rises from bed and puts on his clothes. And he takes his lunch and walks out in the morning light. It's the work, and just the work in life. It's the work, it's the work, and just the work in life.
Phil only wants to do one at a time.
It's only exercise I get.
There's a very nice white rocker back there, that's the only thing.
I failed on my own A-levels first time round, and the only thing that kept me sane for a year at Exmouth was with the rugby club. And I played down there, and all my friends would bugger off. They'd all the bright ones.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I played for Exmouth.
All the bright ones would bugger off, and I wrote a song called Friends about those times when we all got back together again and played music, and I haven't played this for a long time, but it seemed right. One of the first songs that I ever came up with, all about home and all about where we're from, and trying to keep something going. And having invested all those hours in friendship, making sure that the investment doesn't get wasted.
Memories fill the Don't take them on without a fight. Time is money, is all they say. Believe that and you've thrown your friends away.
Jurassic period, whence we all come from. There was this thriving folk scene, as it was mentioned. There were all kinds of places for us relatively young people finding our way into acoustic music to go and play. The Old Fellow's Arms, the Double Locks, the Jolly Porter, and so on. Great places, the Timbers Folk Club. And during that period, I went to Timbers Grammar School. This was a grave clerical error. Someone's appalling waste of public money. But I was kind of the guitar thrasher at my school, and through the shrubbery, there was Timbers Sec Mod School, where the next gentleman was going to come on was the guitarist of his school. And it was inevitable that in the shrubbery we would meet. And instead of searching for love, we would in fact engage with our guitars and go out and do gigs. I think I probably have this gentleman, Mr. Colin Wilson, to thank for dragging me out to the first folk clubs when we were 16 or so. And at that time, I'd never met Steve Knightley, I'd never met Paul Downes. And we all met up on these evenings having fun playing music. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Colin Wilson. We sang lots of songs. We were quite on the contemporary side, and at that time Colin was already writing songs, one of which we're going to sing in the second half. But there was this thriving London folk scene with some great bluesy singers and players on it. And this is a song that was written by a man called Mick Softly, who wrote lots of songs for another man called Donovan. And tonight, at no extra expense, we're going to recreate that moment in 1968. When we first played this song, the Gold Watch Blues.
I went for my interview on the 4th day of July. The personal man, he questioned me until I did cry. He made me feel I should be feeling about the colour of my toilet rolling in my cousin's queer. I'm sure the watch and the shackles for your chains, and a piece of paper saying that you say. And if you've a son who wants to do a career, just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years. He asked how many jobs I had before. He nearly had a heart attack when I answered four. For jobs in 20 years, I was gonna
me outside to where the gravestones stood in line. Well, this is where we bury you, our quick stone and in line. And if you come to work for us, this you must agree, that if you're gonna die, please do it during tea break. There's your gold watch and your shackles for your chain, and you'll be some paper, say you left your saying. And if you've a son who wants a good career, just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years. This story that you've heard, you may think rather queer, but it is the truth, you'll be surprised to hear. I did not want to know the job upon the board. I just wanted to take a broom and sweep the bloody floor. It's your gold watch and the shackles for your chain, and your piece of paper, say you left your saying. And if you've a son who wants a good career, just get him to sign on the dotted line and work for 50 years.
The odd folk, I wonder why.
Yeah.
We were skinny in those days, you know, Col.
Yes, we were.
Yes, we were small men.
We were indeed.
Yes. Yes. We spent years building this. Years. Concentrating, bit
yes.
by bit.
Yeah, bigger in stature, literally.
Calorie by calorie.
So this is, Phil and I used to do a mixture of contemporary and traditional songs, and there was one guy that was on the scene called Peter Bellamy, and he came from Norfolk. And he was very interesting, because he said like this, going round the round board. And we thought, God, we're going to have some of that. That sounds pretty neat. So I bought his album, went down to the Left Bank record shop, plugged in the old earphones. Are you going to buy this record, Sonny, or not? And would you like a bag? It had to be cool with the left hand, you know. So, this is a song that was off his album called John Barleycorn. I remembered it.
Wow.
This is about uninhibited prostitution. It was something very close to filling our hearts at this time. Basis in the 70s, it was free. are you in good voice tonight? What, the three of you? That's great. So you can join in with this song. And the chorus is...
Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down, won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town?
I think we're going a bit fast, Col. Let's just see what happens.
We'll see what happens.
Now, there's absolutely no house rule about singing harmonies. You're welcome to sing harmonies. If you're not sure what a harmony is, just start singing, and when the person next to you stops looking at you, you've found one.
Is that my new sis next to me? I don't know what it was.
In Yarmouth town there lived a man, he kept a tavern by the sun. This landlord had a daughter there, a plump little thing with a golden hair. Won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Oh, lovely one. Now to this tavern came a sailor man, he went to the tavern by the sand. That daughter there, she said, well, I want with you. Oh, won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? But she said, if you want with me to linger, I'll tie a bit of string all around my finger. And if you come by and pull that string, I'll come down and I'll let you in. Won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down, won't you come down, won't you come down to Yarmouth town?
sailor man. He went to the tavern by the sand, then he went and pulled that string. She came down and she let him in. Now, oh, won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Now then, he's never seen such a sight before, 'cause the string round her finger was all she wore. And then he went and pulled that string. She put back the sheets and let Jack in. Oh, won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Now that sailor sailed the whole night through. When he told them all about the maid fair, plump little thing with the golden hair. Won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town?
You're still there.
I'm still there.
I thought you'd be quiet behind the iron.
Now the story that soon got around. The very next night in Yarmouth town, there were 15 sailors pulling on the string. She came down and she let them all in. Oh, won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? So all you young men who walk to Yarmouth do go, see a plump little thing with a hair hanging low. Well, all she's here. All you gotta do is pull that string. She'll come down and she'll let you in. Oh, won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town? Won't you come down? Won't you come down? Won't you come down to Yarmouth town?
Just like it was 1968.
Or was it?
Okay. Keep the show rolling. Two great friends of ours, you've already seen Miranda. This is a couple of songs from Miranda Sykes, our wonderful bass player, and the incredible mandolin playing Mr. Rex Preston. Thank you.
doing two songs. Can we do three?
Yeah.
We're very lucky to have a couple of songs written for us for our last album by a wonderful guy called Boo Hewardine, who's a fantastic singer-songwriter from Cambridgeshire. And he sent us this great little song called Window Box. Robin. We don't get much bird life in our garden. We've got a big cat called Titchy, ironically. He's not. Window box. Lorry to a smart car. in my little head. We're to finish with a little song called Sweet Pea for you. Thanks so much for listening.
Let's hear it for them again, please. You will notice on stage a banjo, which can only mean that we're going to finish the first set with a piece of bluegrass music. For those of you who don't know, bluegrass originated in the swamps and marshes of Dawlish Warren and has spread throughout the world. It's a little song called Columbus, Georgia. We're going to have an interval now. Everybody who's played tonight has CDs and... there's always an awkward moment when musicians have to mention the CDs that they've brought with them. You don't want to be too opportunistic, but my young son, Billy, phoned at about 8 o'clock and said, "Daddy, will Uncle Phil be able to afford a holiday this year?" I want you to think about that during the interview. So we'll finish the first set.
Columbus, Georgia. Oh Lord, I wish I was back in Tennessee, way down in Columbus Stockade Prison. All of my friends have turned on me. Go and leave me if you want to. Never let it cross your mind. In your heart, you love another. Don't you leave me, little darling. With you I travel, darling, countless hours with you I spend. For I have your sweet love and your little heart forever. But now I find they're only left. Go and leave me if you want to. Never let it cross your mind.
Thank you.